Hello friends, this is Pankaj and you are watching AEM tutorial. In this video, we will create a component called hero component and we will be using file upload field. This is the field which allows us to upload an image into the dialog box and save it into the JCR of AEM. And we will also see how you can read that image or file on our component. So this is our website. This is how it looks like. And we had this hero component in our page rendering components. So we had just placeholder of, we just had text of hero component. So we will replace this by the real component. So it will look like this. So we will upload the image using the dialog box. And we will also see how you can read that image in our component. So let's get started. Let me open our AIM instance. So here, I will go to CSD. In apps, we have our project called training. Here, go to the component and content. Here, I will create a hero component. So right click on content, click on create component, and I'm naming it hero. And title as hero image. Click on next, click on OK. Now save it. Open this hero node and rename this hero.jsp by hero.html. Open this file and delete this data. Save it. Now let's see how our website looks like. So go to the site console. And in site console, go to the vtrain or project name. Go to the English, open this. Here you can see we have this hero component text. So we will remove this text by our hero component. So we have this hero text in our page rendering component. So go to the structure, go to the content page, go to the body.html. Here you can see we have this hero component. So here I will use slide data resource and I'll put this component here. So to do that, let me copy this tools here and paste here. And here in this title, keep it hero. And in the title, we have hero component, H-E-R-O. We don't need this class, delete this. So using data-sly-resource, I am embedding this hero component in our page rendering component. Now save it. Now go back to hero.html and put some text here. File upload component, save it and go back to English page. Now refresh this. In this hero component, it should show file upload component. We have successfully included our hero component to this content page component. Now let's create a dialog box for hero component. So let's go to libs. Let me copy the dialog box of image component. So go to libs, WCM, go to the foundation, components. Here we have this image component. So copy this dialog box and come back to our hero component and paste here. Save this. Let's open the CQ dialog. So here we have this image and in this image we have file, title, link URL, description and size. So I don't want to use these three, so I'm deleting these. Save it. Here you can see we have this file which have this file upload section. So slim source type is using file upload. So this allows us to upload the file and here I'm going to upload image. And this is the title, which is a text field which will have the title of our component. So to make this component editable, we need to create editConfig. So create node, write cq colon editConfig. Its name should be like this only, otherwise it won't work. And the type would be editConfig, click on OK. Now save it. Now I will replace this component. So let me copy the code. I have this code already, so let me copy this and paste here. Let me show you what I am doing exactly. Let me zoom it. So yeah. So here you can see I am using some divs, and here I am using property.jsr title. Whatever I will write to dialog box in that text field, it will be shown here. And here I am using some classes for better CSS. And here I have used style. So I'm using inline CSS and showing background image URL. And in this URL, I'm using properties.fileReference. I will show you what is this file reference. And the context is styleString. So actually, and parse slightly does not parse JS and CSS. That's why if we are using CSS, then we need to put context as a styleString. This is very important. Back to the normal zoom. So we have used this properties file reference and context as a style string, and I'm using title. So let's see, go to the dialog. Here you can see in the file where we have file upload section. Here the file reference parameter is file reference. It stores the actual path of the image or any file. So this is why I'm using this properties.fileReference. It will replace this file reference by the path. So now go back to the English page and refresh this page. Here you will see this component has been become, here you can see it has become editable because of editConfig. Here we have image asset. This is the file upload field and this is the title field. Let me put some title, hero component. And let's drop some asset from the assets. So let me put this image and click on OK. So you can see the component has been replaced by this image and this is a title. Let's go back to CXD. So this all happened because of this file reference. It stores the path. So you have to use this file reference parameter to make it possible. Now if you go to the content, go to our vTrain page, go to the English page. Here you can see this hero node. Here we will see this is a file reference and it has stored the path of the image. So now go back to the different page. And again, let's upload some different image here. Go to the edit mode, double click here. And put some title. And put some image here and click on OK. So here you can see the image has been reflected successfully. So this is how you can create the hero component. In my next video, we will see how you can drag and drop this image component directly over to the component without opening the dialog box using editConfig. So we will be using drag and drop functionality of editConfig. So stay tuned. If you enjoyed this video, subscribe my channel, like this video, and share this with your friends. Thanks again for watching.